to your wedding, your marriage, and your lives. What we see here between the two of these is a testimony. Actually, Josh and Jennifer, before they met each other, they had lots of family and friends, right? They had a full life. But neither were sure if or when they would meet that special someone. That's when they both found their completeness in God, in their relationship with God, before they met each other. They found that one. Now, during this time, they did both write a letter, unknowingly to the other, since they didn't know each other, and they put a few things what they were hoping for. They said, Lord, you know, if it's just me and you, it's okay. But if you would send that special someone, I have a few requests. Well, let's see. Jennifer, you asked for someone who had a sense of humor. And Joshua, you asked for someone who would laugh at your jokes. Okay, well, this is how you put it. Someone who would accept me for who I am, humor and all. Jennifer, you asked for someone who would love your kids and be healing and healthy. Joshua, you asked for someone who you could build a family with. And you've shared with many of us here and myself with great excitement and joy, God gave me a ready-made family. While there's more that they wrote private between the two of them, I've saved the best for last. As we talk about God being full of surprises when we invite him in, both Jennifer and Joshua did this in their letters. They both put the same thing as the highest priority. Jennifer, you wrote, love the Lord more than anything in life.
Amen.
And Joshua, you wrote, you asked for someone who had a strong faith in God, who would help you grow in your walk and relationship with God, and grow together in God and minister together. And here each of you are, together, getting married. My advice to you today is, there may be some things that you receive in your relationship that weren't in the letter. Maybe some of our marrieds here can relate. You each ask for someone who loved God, check. Humor, check. Family, check. But there's things that happen in marriages that you don't ask for that aren't on the list. Like wet towels on the floor, squeezing that toothpaste in just the wrong place. Annoying habits. Continued need for emotional healing. The 2-year mark that Pastor Gary suggested. Traumatic events and empty wineskins. You know, Gavin and I have been married for 25 years now, and we've decided and seen and experienced that when you invite Jesus into the good, bad, and the ugly, that there's a deeper kind of love that only he can bring. And that's what we're praying for and we see for the two of you today. Now, there's many other ways that I encourage you to continue to invite the Lord in, and that is continue to listen to your elders. Live in community, don't isolate, and always love each other as Christ loves you. God has many callings for the two of you as a couple. So I encourage you to pray for each other and encourage each other in that and grow together. The world is good at cooling off our faith, so your marriage should be a place that fires up your faith. And I know it will be. You know, it's easy to get married. The trick is to get married, be married, and love being married. Someone once said, a great relationship, a great marriage, is one that you keep falling in love all over again and again with the same person.
Amen.
I would like to add that it's with God's love and his rose-colored wine that we can do this. Now, as I pray for each of you, I feel like the Lord gave me a picture. And it was that you could each look at each other today and say, you answered my letter. Joshua, you could say, Jennifer, you answered my letter. And Jennifer, you could say, Joshua, you answered my letter. And all of us here could say, look, they answered each other's letter. But what the Lord showed me instead is that today, we all take a moment now to see what God has done Look what God has done. God answers your letters. As we begin the marriage vows, we see that Joshua and Jennifer have chosen these vows to express to each other their commitment to each other. And they're making them before God and all of us, so they don't take it lightly. Now, if your spouse is with you, you can recommit and renew and ask the Lord to fill each of you in your heart as we read these. Ask Him for new wine as you recommit with the vows that you made. Josh, repeat after me. I, Joshua, take you, Jennifer.
I, Joshua, take you, Jennifer.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
I promise and covenant.
I promise and covenant.
Before God and His witnesses.
Before God.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
And in sickness and in health.
And in sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
This is my song.
This is my song.
Now, Jennifer, please repeat after me. I, Jennifer, take you, Joshua.
I, Jennifer, take you, Joshua.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
I promise and covenant before God and His witnesses.
I promise and covenant before God and His witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
May we have Jennifer's ring. The wedding ring is a symbol of your lifetime commitment to each other. It's an unbroken circle that reflects God's intention that the marriage bond be unbroken for as long as you both shall live. Joshua and Jennifer have a special ring. It has three diamonds. This represents Joshua, Jennifer, and God. God in the center of their relationships to keep them strong. And now, as a token of your love and your deep desire to be committed in marriage to one another for as long as you both shall live, we will have the exchange of rings. Josh, hold it on the edge of her ring finger. And repeat after me. Jennifer, I give you this ring.
Jennifer, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
To pledge my love to you.
To pledge my love to you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I commit to you.
I commit to you.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Jennifer, do you have the ring? Now, Jennifer, as you place that on his finger, please repeat after me. Joshua, I give you this ring.
Joshua, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
To pledge my love to you.
To pledge my love to you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have. I commit to you.
I commit to you.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
As their first act as married couple, together, Joshua and Jennifer would like to signify the intention God has of two becoming one by lighting the unity candle.
Have a plan for this crazy life. Because it brought you here and placed you by my side. And I have never been so sure of anything before like I am in this moment here with you. Now for better or for worse, so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say.
There's a lot of love here for y'all. So many friends and family, and we love you so much, both of you. And it's a beautiful wedding. There is a saying that I have, and that's, after the wedding comes the marriage. And we hope that today is all you've hoped it would be. But I now ask everyone to please join me in asking God's blessing upon Joshua and Jennifer, and what really comes next, the marriage, your lives together. Dear Father, we thank you for bringing Joshua and Jennifer together in holy matrimony. We thank you for answering Joshua and Jennifer's prayers and letters, which you knew were intended for each other. And we thank you for your wonderful surprises. We thank you that you're the one that fills us. We ask you now to give them all they need on this journey together as husband and wife and a new family. We ask for wisdom. We ask for humility. We ask for self-sacrifice, patience, deeper relationships with each other and with God. May this marriage be a testimony to your goodness. We just thank you today for Joshua and Jennifer and what you've done. In Jesus' name, amen. With the power vested in me by the state of Washington and our Lord Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. To you, Mr. and Mrs. Joshua Lawrence.